In this problem, we're going to look at a problem from an exam as a good review. In this case where we have A goes to B reaction, and we have a more complicated rate expression. But what we've done is plot the rate here, negative of the rate of A, versus the concentration of A. And so you can see at low concentrations of A, the absolute value of the rate of A increases, and at higher concentrations, it decreases. So it says we use an isothermal CSTR, and when we carry out reaction, we observe that there are actually three steady-state solutions to the mass balance. It's isothermal, so there's no energy balance to worry about. We like to avoid this complication and have one solution. And it's suggested that we run the reaction in two isothermal CSTRs in series, where each CSTR is half the volume of the original CSTR, with the same inlet volumetric flow rate. And the question is, will this avoid the multiplicity? Will this avoid us having multiple solutions? And then will the conversion be higher or lower? So there's several approaches we can use. Let's take advantage of this graph. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to write down steady state mass balance for CSTR. Steady state for component A, the reactant. We have volumetric flow rate in, concentration in. Assuming that the volumetric flow rate is the same leaving, concentration, and the rate of reaction times volume. Because I have a plot of negative rate of reaction, I'm going to put that on the left side. And then on the right side, I have this, which I'll rearrange in terms of the space-time, time in the reactor, tau, the volume of the reactor divided by the volumetric flow rate. Now, the problem does not give me the value of the inlet concentration nor the value of tau, but it gives me the solutions, and so I can look at this graph. I have a plot of this as a function of the concentration. So that means if I plot this also as a function of concentration, the intersections of those two plots should be the solutions. Now notice this right-hand side, this is just linear in the concentration of A. So if I identify the three solutions for the exit concentration in this reactor, and I draw a straight line through them, that straight line is going to be the right-hand side of this equation. So I have indicated the three exit concentrations that are solutions, and I've drawn a straight line through corresponding to the right side of the mass balance. That means CA0 must be here. I want to compare this to reactor of half the size. So if I look again at my balance, if reactor is half the size, so T2, a new reactor would be T1 over 2. And so that means the right side of the equation now for when we have two reactors together, the right side is going to be over my original tau. The absolute value of the slope is doubled. So I just need to start here, since we have the same inlet concentration. I need to draw, again, linear line with an absolute slope that's twice this. That would correspond to my first reactor in series. Here is now the first of two reactors, the right side of the equation. So when I have two reactors in series, then the exit concentration, namely this value from the first reactor, is going to be the inlet concentration of the second reactor. So this will be coming into reactor. The slope is going to be the same because the volume is the same. The volumetric flow rate is the same. So I'm going to have a line parallel to this first one that corresponds now to the second reactor. This then is the concentration in the second reactor, around 0.95 for Ca. And now we can answer the questions that were posed originally. Will this avoid multiplicity, and will the conversion be higher or lower? So the answer is Yes, it avoids multiplicity. We only have one solution now. But the conversion is lower. The concentration of A is higher. We're operating in the lower reaction regime. With these particular conditions, two reactions series, we don't take advantage of the high reactions that are present at the high conversions.